Welcome back, guys. Thanks for taking time to spend a little time with me. Always appreciate that. And Still a Nation. How you feeling today, Still a Nation? I got to ask that question. Let me talk to you real quick about Still a Nation. Still a Nation is so funny. You're so finicky. You watch all of these other guys getting signed and all these deals being made, and all y'all can say is, man, the Steelers ain't doing nothing. Man, they sitting on their hands. Man, they sleep. And look at this. Look at this. Omar Khan strikes again. In case you haven't heard, the Pittsburgh Steelers will be signing Patrick Queen. Yes, Patrick Queen, 25-year-old inside linebacker who has been a stellar standout for the Baltimore Ravens. The Pittsburgh Steelers will be signing him to a 3-year deal. I think I saw worth $41 million. I don't have all of the particulars yet, but I wanted to come on here and give a quick reaction to it. You know I'll be talking about it later on tonight. Later on tonight, shameless plug, boom, right there in the corner. Terrible Towel Tuesday tonight. Tonight, special time, 9 p.m. Eastern time. Normally at 8, but tonight, got to delay it to 9 p.m. Eastern time. Make sure you come by. Phone queue will be open, and we'll be talking Patrick Queen as well as Russell Wilson. But anyway, guys, let's get back to how I feel about this. Listen, first of all, shout outs to Omar Khan, Mike Tomlin, Art Rooney II, whoever is responsible for this. It is good to see this because the Pittsburgh Steelers, generally what they like to do is they like to get these young guys on their second contract. That is what they always prefer to do in free agency. Youth, second contract. You can't do better than this scenario. You know, maybe some guys would have said, hey, maybe they should have gone after Devin White, whichever one of those guys you like better. Regardless, the scenario cannot beat that scenario. A 25-year-old inside linebacker who is a been there, done that type of guy. Not only is he a been there, done that, he's done it in the AFC North. He did it with the Baltimore Ravens. So we already know what type of mentality and the type of grit he's coming with. Not to mention, he'll play the Baltimore Ravens 2 times per year. So maybe he gives us a little bit of insight. Maybe he's able to key in on one Lamar Jackson or now Derrick Henry. I'm just saying, you can't do better than that. Bravo, excellent job by the Steelers organization. Again, Mike Tomlin, Omar Khan, man, the Khan artist. I love it. I love them being aggressive. Again, I told you guys, man, free agency will let me see exactly where they may go in the draft. I was getting a little concerned. You know, I see a lot of the top centers already being signed, but, you know, we'll save that for tonight. We'll talk a little bit about that tonight. Right now, I just want to again highlight Patrick Queen. I love it. I have nothing bad to say about it. Listen, do I know all of Patrick Queen's pros and cons? I don't. I haven't done a film analysis or a film study on Patrick Queen. I know this dude has played very well for the Baltimore Ravens. What I would like to see, and I need to take a look at, you know, how well he, you know, covers the pass. And I know even against us, Patrick Queen has done good things defending the middle of the field against the Pittsburgh Steelers, against tight ends, both him and Roquan Smith, when they became a tandem, would do that from time to time. So, listen, I have nothing bad to say about this right now. It's just my early knee-jerk reaction. And again, you know, doing my duty to bring this information to you guys who love to hear my thoughts. I love it. I love it. I have nothing bad to say at this moment. And maybe by later on tonight, maybe there's another signing we're talking about. But right now, Pittsburgh Steelers have gone aggressive at the inside linebacker position, which, again, I think is a great move because I don't know if there's a rookie that you trust to come in and, you know, take the lead. So right now, you look at it like this. You're going to get Patrick Queen more than likely paired with a Cole Holcomb or whoever else they plan to play inside linebacker because I'm not 100% sure. I think both Landon Roberts and Quan Alexander, I think they were on 1-year deals. I think Cole Holcomb is the only one that might be under contract. I could be wrong there. But either way, I'm cool with that pairing, and I'm even cool with them drafting a guy to play alongside of Patrick Queen. So now you have a guy who's, for one, solidified as an inside backer, right? You have that worthy veteran, that do it all inside backer, and you can help groom the next guy beside him. So that's what I'm hoping they're doing. You know, if they can't retain all of the guys that were on the roster last year, I would love for them to also be proactive and go draft an inside linebacker to play alongside Patrick Queen, right? That's how you do it. I would love for them to do that. But as of right now, again, I have no complaints about this signing. You know, maybe my feelings change if I find out more information after reviewing film. I doubt it. But this is just my knee-jerk reaction. Right now, I would love to see the Steelers land a safety as well. That would be awesome. But we'll see. We'll take what we have for now. So far, all we know is Russell Wilson, the punter Cameron, I can't remember his last name, but the kid from Houston, and now Patrick Queen. Yo, feeling good so far about what the Steelers are doing in free agency so far. So that's all I got for this particular video. Again, come back tonight, man. Come back tonight for this right here. Terrible Towel Tuesday. Tonight it will be at 9 p.m. Eastern time. Again, 9 p.m. as opposed to 8. Tonight is at 9 p.m. Phone queue will be open. I look forward to taking your calls, hearing your thoughts, your hate, your love, whatever it is you feel about the current state of the team. I'll be looking forward to hearing that from you tonight. Outside of that, man, the only thing else I'm just going to ask you to do, if you haven't already, if you like the video, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, turn on those notifications. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.